look out my window. Many sights to see. And when I look in my window, so many different people to be. They're strange, so strange. It's very strange to me. You got to pick up every stitch. You got to pick up every stitch. You got to pick up every stitch. Oh no.
Hi, it's Madam again. How you doing tonight? It's a little warm here, a little sultry, a little sweaty. It's fun. I am so glad that summer is finally arriving in Iowa because it's been really kind of shitty and cold, but my hair is taking the brunt of it. It was all nice and curly at one point, but not now. Hi, Sam. Is it hot where you are too? It's hot here in Iowa now. So anyway, tonight I get to tie him up. He thinks he's going home. No, he really will at some point. Anyway, tonight I want to talk about bondage. I do like bondage, not done on me, of course. I kind of have a thing about restrictive bondage. I really don't like to be tied up like that. It kind of gives me a thing and a certain kind of feeling that I don't like to feel. So, but I like to tie other people up, and it comes from my love of rope. And when I was a kid, we had horses, and I would, you know, make a bridle out of rope, you know, and you could, you know, you'd tie your horse up all the time and make sure they didn't get away, because if they did, you'd be the laughing stock of the town for several days. And your horse would go home without you, and everyone would wonder what happened, and they'd find you walking home, you know, without the horse. It was always a little bit of an embarrassment. So, but these are leg cuffs, and they can be used to hang someone upside down. I have a winch in the basement, and you can attach their feet to it and then just wind them right up. And Dylan has been kind enough to let me hang him upside down on a couple of occasions. And this is so fun. But then these are the arm cuffs. But you should never, ever, ever, ever hang anyone from their arms. It's not good. It'll cut off circulation. It's just don't do it. Not ever. And let's see, your thumb goes through that. So it's this one. Like that. So anyway, and then you get them all tied up in there, and they can that one goes, geez, I haven't used these for a while. Anyway, is it the other hand? I thought that kind of went over your thumb. Here, let's try that. Oh, okay, like that. Yeah, there we go. Now we got, now we're going somewhere. Now we're using gas. And then, you know, you can, they make what's called a St. Andrew's cross, and then you can use these to tie them into the cross, but that's really tight. And then you go this way across that one. Yeah, across with that one. But you see, there's a lot of buckles and straps involved in bondage often. I'm not going to put it all the way on it. No, I got something else for that. A lot of buckles and straps and hardware, you know. But I'm not really into that stuff. I figure they're not really trying to get away. I go based under the assumption they don't really want to get away. So these are good enough. And these are, I made myself. My friend is a dom as well. And we do dom crafts at his house and we make things for our subs. So I'm going to put this on and see how easy that is. And they're so lightweight. It's like one step above the fuzzy handcuffs. Oh Lord, the fuzzy handcuffs. I have some on the rearview mirror of my ride. There we go. So those are nice and they're comfortable and they distribute that like the pole evenly. But I never, you don't hang people by their arms anyway. No, they have ankles for that. So anyway, here, let's give you a pair. And then I want to show, I have another pair of cuffs too that are just super de-duper. I had a rope bunny, we'll call him. Rope bunnies are people who enjoy being tied up and then they try to get away. You know, that's part of the game is I'll tie you up and then let's see if you can get away. And he was pretty successful. I think he was probably more successful than I was at the game. I haven't seen him for a while. So Rope Bunny, if you're listening, pop on in or hop on in. But these, I said, I want them because I want something they can't get out of. And so then the guy got me these out of the back room. And actually I bought them at a fair. And there'll be another fair coming soon. Actually, Saturday night is, and I'm going to give them a plug because these guys are awesome. There's Saturday night in Davenport, Iowa, at the Village Theater. There'll be Muddy Water Mayhem. And I will be there, Madam Mayhem. And I think the beautiful Dylan will be there as well. And here, let's try these on. So then they have a big party and gathering of BDSM people and just people in general, you know, if you enjoy that sort of scene, music and entertainment and some drinks and things. There'll be some demonstrations on things like flogging and people you can talk to, you know, if you're interested in things like that. There'll be a little bit of, a couple people selling their wares because this is always handmade stuff, you know. At the fairs, they made it themselves, you know, and they put a little bit of good intention in there that, you know, the subject would not get away. All right. So then, you know, you got them on this chain, and I found though, you got to make sure that their arm cannot reach the chain. So you got to stretch them out a little bit, because if they can reach it, they let themselves go. Imagine that. Oh, Lord. So, anyway. Get this one on. Oh, it's kind of tight. They're so nice. And they're heavy duty. They are really heavy duty. And I would plug the guy I got them from, but I can't remember his name. If I remember later, I will say. So, and let's see. Now we're moving on to rope, my favorite. But yeah, we used to like make bridles and stuff for our horses out of rope and just ride them around, you know, ride around the field or wherever. And then this is a daisy chain. Keeps your rope nice and tidy so that, you know, you don't go and have, you know, pile of tangled rope that you're working with because then it takes you know, a little of the fun out of it because you're spending an hour trying to get it straightened out. So it's nice. It's therapeutic. I enjoy that, but not, you know, only at certain times. All right. So we're going to do a double column. And so I have him just put his hands like this. Okay. And then I run it. And then you take, this is called your bite. It's the middle of the rope. So you take both the ends, put them together, and then go back to the other end. That's your bite on your rope. And you have to use that middle portion. It's an anchor point. So then you run the rope on through. Okay. And then for this one, you go around. And I try to make it flat, you know, as they're... as I'm winding it so that it's comfortable for them. And if at any point in time it feels uncomfortable, please let me know. Okay. You got to communicate with your subject. Because, you know, sometimes you get people tied in these really awkward positions. And, you know, you want them to, like, let you know if the blood flow is, you know, stopped to their hands or something. And, you know, you got to check it, too. You got to make sure their hands are still warm as they should be, you know, and then you go through the middle and then through the middle again. And then you pull it. Is that okay? Is it too tight?
It's a little bit tight.
Can you wriggle it loose a little bit?
That's pretty good.
There? Okay. So you gotta communicate. Alright, so then I'm gonna tie it off and so it won't get tighter, I think. How's that? You good? Mm-hmm. All right. And then so with this, you could, you can then tie them to something else, you know, like if I wanted to tie them down to something, or if I just wanted to, like, you know, take him around town, sport him around town a little bit, he'd just be, you know, tied up and really can't go anywhere. And so I think I'll keep him right there for the rest of the day. Ah, kidding. He wanted to go home. So so anyway, that was the whole thing. I'll show you single chain column. Sorry, this is double column because they're too tied together. We'll do a single column. And then I'm going to release from bondage Dylan. He's got to go home. But anyway, there we go. Unbinding can be fun too. And honestly, ladies, it's really great foreplay. yeah, it just, you know, it puts you at the advantage, which, you know, may or may not happen in your regular lives, you know. It's just, it's fun. So let's just have one hand. So this one I'm going to do over the thumb and then cross over because I don't want to go over the arteries and stuff right, like directly. So I'm going to go down and so that I'm not going over them. And this one you have to kind of keep tension on in order to keep it, you know, the way it is. Otherwise, if you lose tension, you lose all of the whole tie. So you have to start over again. The feet are kind of like that too, which, we have the feet. All right, so then go this way. And a lot of this stuff is, it's like weaving almost, you know? So that should be good enough. I'm gonna go here, and then I'm gonna go this way, and then this way, and then we're gonna go this. So you're gonna take your thumb out of there, and you're gonna tuck that in like that. And then I'm gonna take this piece and feed it through like that. And then I can do this and tie it off there, and then it won't get any tighter. But can you get away? Try pulling and getting away. Oh, he did get away.
Yeah.
See, that's the fun of the game, though, is, you know, I'll tie you. You see if you can get away. It's fun for me. I don't know. Did you enjoy that?
Yeah.
There you go.
Usually, like if both my hands were tied at the same time, it'd be a little harder too.
Well, yeah, yeah. The single column is a little easier to escape. But you know, if you're tying them separate, you can't tie them together. Like if they're on a cross, you know, like St. Andrew's cross or something, or you know, if you had them tied down like spread eagle on the bed. I don't know. I really don't know anything about that. I have a harness under the bed because I don't have like a bed frame you can tie anything to. So a friend, Chris, shout out, hey, showed me how to tie it under the bed. So it looks like a big H, you know, and it has the four corners that come out, and it works pretty good. And pulleys. Pulleys are good too. So then, yeah, that kind of gets everything up and out of the way. thank you very much. And thank you for your assistance. This is my lovely assistant, Dylan.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks for coming. Yeah. All right. I'll see you soon. Uh-huh. Oh, you never did show me what you're going to wear to the event this weekend.
Yeah,
but that's okay. I'll see you tomorrow or something.
I can take pictures. Yeah.
Do that. Send me pictures. That'd be great. So, yes, we're getting ready for our Muddy Water Mayhem event. So it should be fun. I'm excited about it, you know. And then I wanted to just like a PSA kind of thing. It is really stinking hot now, pretty much everywhere in the United States. So drink lots of water. I like to put fruit and stuff in mine. And so it's just good. I'm going to get a drink real quick. All right. So there we go. And I have an alarm on the door. That way, if I'm in the back of the shop, I know somebody came in front. So it's like, hey, what's up? It's good. It's just water with fruit in it. And you eat the fruit as the, you know, you just drink the water. And it's good and good for you. You got to stay hydrated. Oh, that's so good. And do they bark if you ask? Well, yes, if I ask, they probably would. It's all in fun. You know, it's sometimes it's fun to get outside of yourself and just pretend to be someone else or something else, you know, and just kind of just be free with your imagination. And I do what they call pony play. And it's just exactly what it sounds like. You get a pony and I'm getting a cart. A friend of mine is going to be making a cart soon, and we're going to do ponies. Hi, Don. We're going to be ponies, and he's going to be the pony, and I'm going to be in the cart driving the pony. I used to have horses, and so it's exciting for me because I get to drive my horse cart again. But my horse has only got two legs instead of four, but you know, it's okay. And I've had no end to the offers of being my pony. I was very surprised by that. I was like, really? Because they were kind of like, well, what do you mean you got a pony? I thought I was going to be your pony. I said, well, there's plenty of room for pony, all kinds of ponies in my stable. I'll have a pony every day. So anyway, that sounds fun. And so summertime's here, and that's the kind of stuff we're going to be doing around here. We're going to have a little pony play and some kayak races and, you know, whatever. It'll be fun. It's fun on the river. I love life on the river. And I know it doesn't, you know, well, that I have to say, it does kind of tie in with bondage, because when your boat is out there on the river, you want to be sure that your knots are tied and that your rope is secure, because otherwise your boat will not be there when you come back. And so that's always a drag too. You never want that happening. Yeah, you come out in the morning and you go, where's the boat at? So yeah, you wanna make sure your anchor line is secure. And I did learn a lot of rope tying and things like that from my dad, Mark. You know, he was a great guy, and he knew everything about boats, and he taught me just a ton. This used to be a boat shop. There's a boat motor back there. It was the boat shop, and it was a great place. And if you were out on the river and you needed help, all you had to do was go there. So They were just very kind people who helped everyone, you know, get by out on the river. Because if you didn't have help out there, if people didn't just stop and help one another out there on the river, you would be so screwed, because there's no one else out there, you know. And nowadays it's bad because there's not as many pleasure boaters as there used to be. And so if each one of them, you know, didn't try to help the person in need, you would just be out there for a long time. So it's sort of the code of the river that if somebody's stranded out there, you stop and help them and at least get them to the shore where they can take care of things on their own. So, but yeah, you get them off the river. And so, yeah, it's kind of just the way people live. And I like that because it means they're kind, you know, and they care about other people. And I appreciate that, especially in today's world. It's hard to find people like that at times. Uh-oh, I hope I don't get feedback now because I'm... Does anybody know any other way to share this stupid show? If you did, let me know, because I'm really having a bad time with this. I think if I do that, and then, okay, it's on my clipboard now, I think, so I can share a link. I have a hard time sharing and showing at the same time. Oh, fun. Anyhow, you guys are great. Anybody who's stuck around this long is awesome. I kind of was hoping to have more demonstration stuff. And then pictures. I realize now you can't show pictures on the platform unless they are in the form of a PowerPoint. So I've got to do like a slideshow PowerPoint to get them into this, StreamYard. So FYI, anybody who wanted to show pictures, you're going to have to put it together as a slideshow with your PowerPoint or something like that in order to get it in. So I'm learning. This has been a huge learning experience. It's insane. And I really am happy for having had the chance to do it. Because technology is really, the knowledge of technology is everything now. Everything is online. Everything is on your computer. Everything's computerized. And if you don't, you know, have the capacity to share that information, it kind of, you know, sucks. It sucks. Mosquitoes, they're starting to come. And that's just... It's that time of year. I don't run the air. You guys are going to think I'm crazy. I don't have air conditioning on purpose. I just don't like it. You keep your house closed up all winter long, and then in the summertime, you close it up again. It's like, when do you ever get to open your windows and just enjoy being outside or enjoy the outdoors, the great outdoors? I just like to do that. And if I can get by without air conditioning, that's just that much more money that does not go into the pocket of the electric company. So, yeah, I'm kind of stingy with them too. I would like to have more, solar power. I have some, I've gone solar with some stuff and, super happy about it. And, I'd like to get some hydroelectric going. There's a river full of power out there. And I'd like to get it going. So anybody who knows about hydroelectric power, message me. Because it's stuff I'm interested in. And anything that keeps money out of the pocket of the electric company, I'm okay with it. I think the utilities, and there's a lot. Jeez, I shouldn't probably even get started on all the mainstay stuff. Oh, it says it's unavailable. Well, that stinks. Stinkerini. Oh, well. I tried at least this time. I have a hard time getting this stuff to share or whatever. I don't know. We'll see what happens here. All right. Anyway. Oh, everybody left. Yep, I was sharing. So I get kind of, you know, when there's another person on, it's great, you know, and you can like say, hey, share that while I'm talking, you know, doing my thing. But yeah. Oh, we forgot to talk about different kinds of rope. Because I have different kinds. And there's the pink one that I used. This is like a cotton rope. This is also cotton, but it's a little softer. And when you're talking about tying somebody up, soft rope is good. It feels good on your skin. It really does. And then this is nylon rope. It's braided nylon, which is okay. What you don't want is this is the filled nylon. See, this is all like braided together. This is like a filled nylon, and it's not good. You wouldn't want to hang from this because I do self-suspension as well, and you do not want to suspend yourself with this because it can break inside of the cover, and then it's weakened, and you might not know it, and you can drop to the floor. So, you know, when you're 15 feet or 10 feet off the floor, you don't really want to drop onto the hard concrete. And so, yeah, it's just something to watch. And so any of this, like, filled stuff, you can use it for, you know, just messing around rope. But I wouldn't put any, like, real weight on it. You know, I wouldn't depend on it, let's say. But this stuff's better. Actually, this stuff, we lifted my boat off the ground with this stuff and hung it on the ceiling. So I know it's good. Good rope. It'll hold you. And so, and it's made of nylon and they braid it together. And so it's solid and it will keep you from, keep your stuff from falling or, you know, keep somebody from getting away. I made these all the same length. Like I had 100 feet of rope and I just made 4, you know, for arms and then legs. And so then you can tie people, you know, by all 4 points. That's fun. And, I'm always like, that's the first thing for me. That's the go-to. Drop your clothes and I tie them up. So, you know, people are like, aren't you nervous? You know, or cause I, on occasion, people I don't know super well. I mean, you know, I kind of, and you talk to them enough that, you know, and, they will come over and they're more scared than I am, I'm sure. And so then, yeah, I put them at a disadvantage right away. Remember that, ladies, when you're on a date, you know, it's okay to make them feel a bit uncomfortable. Like, oh boy, I really better watch what I'm doing here with her because she could be, you know, dangerous if you provoke her. Oh, Lord. Yeah, I carry mace. I carry a taser. And that's just the little stuff. You know, I've got a handgun and knives. I like knives. Knives are nice. And, you know, if it ever came down to it, knives are pretty multi-purpose. Oh, Lord. Everybody's got to have a good knife and swords and, you know, any other kind of nunchucks and whatever. Weaponry of all sorts. I do enjoy weaponry. If I could say it correctly. All right. Time to hydrate. I have Alexa remind me to hydrate. And she'll say, House of Mayhem, it's time to hydrate with water. She says with water because she knows me so well. Good stuff. And my allergies are just going crazy because it's summertime in Iowa and it's bad.
Pardon me, folks.
Pardon me while I take care of that. Oh, darn, it's empty. Oh my God, I could own a tissue factory. I told Bob, I said, Bob, when I get really, really wealthy, first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to buy you a cat food factory. Oh, because he's always so concerned that, you know, he might not get to eat again. He kind of, that's the way he acts about things, you know. Like, oh, my God, I'm never going to eat again. And then, you know, a couple hours later, he's eating again. Yeah, Bob thinks I might not feed him on occasion, but no, I really will. These are so great. These were given to me by someone, and I almost wish I had someone to hang up in the basement, because that was just so darn fun. And I could show you the video, but it has some, like, actual nudity, and I can't show that on Facebook, because I'd probably get in Facebook jail. And I'm lucky to say, knock on wood, I haven't been in Facebook jail for a really long time, and I'm okay with that. And so I thought, you know, I'd try to, like, show you enough, but not so much that I get in Facebook jail. And that's tough to do some days. Because I just don't have enough stuff that's, like, PG rated. I mean, I got all kinds of stuff I'd love to share with you guys, but I can't because it's PG rated. And OnlyFans made a mess of my page. I don't even know what the hell's going on over there now. I need to go find out, though. Ooh, ants. Duck. Anyway, yeah, I need to go find out what's up with that, because I used to have a really nice OnlyFans page, and it was it had a lot of good stuff on it, too. Really good stuff. Like demonstration of, you know, the electric fly swatter. Yeah, I have the live demonstration of that. And then I have one of my subs had a strange request. He wanted me to make him anal beads. You know, anal beads. They're about maybe this big around, really small. And I said, okay. And he says, out of golf balls. Okay. And so I did. I made them out of golf balls, and he demonstrated them on camera for me. And so that was rather interesting. It has yet to see the light of day. I think that may have been the thing that actually got me attention enough to get booted from, or not, you know, the boot, but they went through all my videos and just, like, decimated my whole page. And so I think that might have been the thing that got the ball rolling, was that video. I don't know. Well, it'll be a mystery of the ages. not that I care. So, oh, okay. I see. Gotcha. Not a problem. So, anyway, yes, it's been quite an adventure in BDSM. And I can't believe that I've had the opportunity to do some of the things that people have actually consented to. Yeah, it's been good. It's been a learning experience. And the thing I still don't get, though, is what makes people want this stuff? You know, like somebody would ask me to restrictively tie them. Okay, they want to be put in a straitjacket. Which I have a straitjacket as well. I should have shown that it's restraint, right? Next time. Anyway, so they want to be put in the straitjacket. They want to be hog-tied. And then they want to be so restrictively tied so that they can't even move a toe. And then just put some smelly socks in their face and leave them alone. Maybe come back every now and then and taunt them. About whatever, you know, how small their dick is or whatever. Their choice in clothing. I don't know. Anyway, but it's just, it's amazing to me the things that people will commit, they'll consent to. I don't know. I there's a lot I will not consent to. And I think that's why I'm the dom, because I'm not going to do that. You know, it's like, no, don't tie me restrictively. I wouldn't like it. I would probably throat punch you and let me loose. And it's Bob. Anyway, there's a lot of things that I just am not down for that I will do to other people, you know. I just don't want anyone doing it to me. But it's just the way it is. Bob, he's been loving it because he's going in and out, in and out, in and out. And he likes that. He likes that stuff. Ugh, now I'm going to have Bob hair all over me. He'll probably sneeze. Anyway, it's flea and tick season too, so be sure that you get all your animals or flea and tick stuff. It sucks when they get fleas. Then they bring them in the house, and then you have fleas. You live with Fleaby the cat. Oh dear. Okay. I can show you the daisy chain. This keeps the rope from getting all nasty and tangled up like this. It's terrible. Sometimes it's therapeutic to just sit with the rope and untangle it and, get it put the way it should be. And there we go. These ends, too. This is just disgraceful. I can't believe I'm even showing this, but look at that. That's bad. I should have, done something more like that. You just burn the end and you kind of poke it, but not with your finger. Jeez. Just on the paper or whatever, and just kind of make sure it's all tamped down so it's not scratchy. You don't want the end to be scratchy. You might scratch it. Some sensitive area. Because I do also dick tie. I will put dicks in bondage, and it's good. I like it. I feel like it's just a fun thing to do, and then when I take it off, it's like a helicopter. It's fun. I think so. And so far, not too many complaints. Maybe one or two little crybabies, but that's the thing. Bondage, being a sub is not for crybabies, because when you're a sub, you pretty much get to, you're doing whatever your dom would like you to do, because you're there to please them and make them happy and fulfill all their needs. So, I love it when guys think only of one need and not the thousand other more needs that are actually probably at the forefront for her. And so, they're sometimes disappointed when they find out that my main need in life is to have someone come do my dishes while they're naked. And right now, that is my number one need. So, I don't know what you were thinking, guys, but that's what I'm thinking. And that's probably what a lot of my girlfriends are thinking, too, vacuuming. Yeah, you can do it naked. Sure. Go ahead. Fine. So then anyway, what you do is I just kind of put like a little tie at the top. So I got something to hook onto. But then you just do this back and forth and forth. Just pull the end through. And then make your rope nice and little daisy chain. Nice and straightened out. So then next time you go to use it, it just pops right out. My ex's dad, he taught me a lot about tying and things, and also old Glenn Underwood. He's passed away now, but he was an old cowboy, and he would have, they had like a little mini rodeo out at his place, like every Wednesday night or something, and they'd rope calves, and they did all kinds of cowboy stuff, cowboys gotta have rope. And he taught me how to rope a calf. Was good stuff. Calf roping. But I learned how to do it on this little calf head on a sawhorse. But I had fun. It was a fun childhood. I did a lot of horsemanship, horse stuff, I was an equestrian. My horse would barely run the barrels. She just wanted to kind of walk, and I'm trying to get her to go. And she just wouldn't do it. And so, I was the comedy relief at the rodeo. Oh, Lord, I got cat hair on me. I feel itchy now. Damn it. Thanks, Bob. anyway, there's my daisy chain. It's all nice and tidy and ready to go for being tied up again. That's the thing. It's really nice if you keep your rope somewhat tidy, because otherwise you're just spending time doing that when you should be spending time tying someone up. I don't know. I suppose there's a lot of people out there that do like to be tied up. I know a few that enjoy just being tied up, because you look at it this way. When you're tied up, you really got to know where you have to be. I mean, where are you going to go? Nowhere. Where'd you go? In nowhere. Because you're tied up. So it's sort of relaxing, because at that point, you just have to just be there. Just exist. Tied among the rope. Chains, too. You can use chains for bondage. I forgot to talk about chains. I have a lot of chain. I sometimes will chain people down, especially the rope bunnies. The rope bunnies get really ingenious. And there comes a point at which it's like, I'm not going to play fair anymore. I am just going to tie you down any way I can so that you do not get away. And so then, you know, you might resort to some chains. They're not, like, you know, not as flexible as rope. Of course, I don't think I can get them as tight as I can rope either. But there's a critical point. You don't want to get somebody wrapped up in chains so tight that they can't function. You know, you don't want to lose any circulation. That's always bad. If you go up to them and their hands are ice cold, probably want to let them go. Might have had a little too much bondage at that point, especially if they really are struggling to get away. I do pretty well at tying knots that are, they don't get tighter. But if you are not real well versed in your knots and you tie it so that it gets tighter and tighter, you're going to have a problem. So, and never tie over the radial artery, you know, over the wrist there. I tied him, but I didn't tie directly over this area. So, because that's where the blood vessels come through, you know, your carpal tunnel. And if that gets squeezed off, you can really have some issues. It'll be like carpal tunnel. It'll be painful, and it'll be painful, and then it'll be cold, and that, and yeah, it's bad. This is the sort of rope that I have a bag that I put my rope in. It's like a mesh bag, and then you can throw it in the washing machine and wash it. So I do wash my rope, but I use this for dick tie. It's this parachute cord. I think I probably got it at the dollar store. But it's such a pretty color. I like it. And what I'll do is you take the bite end, you know, your end that's the round. You know, this is the other half. Like, you fold it in half, and then you go back to the end, and that's the bite. And you can take it and go around the balls and the dick and all that, and then pull it real tight, you know, and it'll make like a ring around it. And then you can, that's like your anchor. And then you can go from there. And this is your anchor. So then the dick and balls would be in there. And you can just sort of cinch it tight as you need to. And then go around. You know, always making sure it lays flat, because if it doesn't, it's a bit uncomfortable. And you can even, like, split the balls, you know, split it and then go around each way. Experiment. It's fun. It's fun to experiment with rope. Just always be safe, sane, and make sure it is consensual, because you don't want to tie someone up when they're, like, going, no, no. Or better yet, they go to sleep and they wake up tied up, like Gulliver's Travels. Oh, the Lilliputians, you know, had him all tied up when he woke up. Yeah, I know that's bad. And that would be non-consensual. So, you know, don't try that at home. Unless it's, you know, your husband or whatever. And they consented to pretty much anything when they said, I do. I'm kind of kidding, not kidding, but, you know, it is what it is. When you're with someone for a really long time, I think you have to try new stuff. You really do. Because if you don't, things just are so dry and dull and boring. And that's the last thing you want to. Those are the last adjectives you really want to use to describe your relationship or your sex life. Dry, dull, and boring. yeah, I think it's at that point that we start to lose interest in our mate. And, you know, that doesn't really bring us closer to them. And I think, you know, bondage could maybe be the thing that gets people back together again. Because when you're tied up, what the heck else are you going to do? You're going to stay there and talk to me about stuff. How do you like me now? Oh, dear. That's pretty, yeah, your captive audience. If there was ever a time you wanted to just, you know, tell them anything or whatever and not be concerned about their reaction, that would be a good time. Because when you got them tied up, they can react however they want. And they're still not going anywhere. can you tell I really like bondage? I really do. I love working with rope. Just the feel of it, you know. And, like, you can, like, I don't know, it's just so versatile. I mean, you can tie somebody up. You tie something up. You can use it for a hoist. You can pull stuff up. You can pull stuff down. You can tie stuff up with it, you know, make sure that it's covered. You can build a shelter if you got some rope. Rope and a piece of tarp, you're in business, man. You got a shelter. So rope can be very handy to have. You know, keep a couple pieces in your car, you know, a little 25, 50 foot piece of rope. If you ever go off the road, you can potentially get towed out with it, you know, depending, you know, if you hit a little patch of ice and you're off the shoulder or something, somebody needs to do something. But, you know, I'm hillbilly, so I'm the kind of woman that drags a marine engine down the street tied to the back of my ride with rope. That's right, folks. I'm a hillbilly. Yeah, I'm a riverbilly, I guess is what we're actually called. But, you know, I'm just the kind of woman that is not really going to let social convention stop me from doing whatever it is I want to do. And so, I'm Madam, and I've been loving, enjoying being here with all of you, whether it was live or if it was Memorex. I really enjoy spending time talking about these subjects with you guys. And if you have any questions or if you'd like to just chit-chat, you can contact me through the Skeleton Key Network, and I'll put the banner on for you guys right there. So submit your questions for Madam to skeletonkeywitches@gmail.com. And if I don't see it right away, one of our skeleton key witches in general will see. Somebody will pick it up and we'll get it to the right person. If it happens to be a question for one of the other ladies on the other shows, for Jess or for Terry or, you know, anybody, just give us a shout out. And if you aren't a stalker, you might get a hold of us. I'm kidding. I've had a stalker or two, but, you know, hopefully those days are gone. I have lots of cameras and weaponry, so I'm not too worried. You know, you'll have that happen on occasion. If you're in the public eye, so to speak. So it is what it is. And there's so many weird things that happen in life anymore. I just don't even get excited about stuff. Not in that fashion. You know, I used to be a little bit more dramatic about things, but I try to keep that at a minimum nowadays and just go with the flow. Another day, different stalker. Oh, gosh. Okay. So I am going to sign off for this evening. And I just want to thank everyone who joined me or who will join me for watching. And I hope I didn't bore you too badly. Next Monday, we are going to be coming to you. Dawn and I are going to be coming to you with some paranormal news. And we're going to let you know what's going on out there in the world of paranormal. And if it's not newsworthy, we won't be reporting it. It's not newsworthy unless we're reporting it. How's that? So so we're going to bring some stuff to you that I think nobody's really been telling about, you know, things that people are doing, like new investigations and stuff, like exciting stuff that's happening out there right now. But you don't really hear about it, at least not in one place, you know. And so hopefully that's what we're going to bring to you is all your paranormal news in one spot. And it'll be great. And I'm really looking forward to working with Dawn. And I think that we're going to have a good time. And we're going to have some good information. And I'd like all of you to join us. We'll be, of course, on the Skeleton Key Network. We'll be also on the Temple, Temple of Phoenix Rising Entertainment. And we'll be with them as well. And we're going to try and swing things, but I think we have a schedule conflict. So sadly, I don't think we'll be on there. But I was going to see if maybe we could somehow share it to their page after the live. And so then people over there can catch it too, because it's going to involve all paranormal, everybody, you know, everybody in one spot. And, you know, include UFO sightings as well as contact with spirits. Because it's all good, and I think for us to learn about what's out there in the universe is a great thing. So I hope all of you guys learn what's you know, in your universe. I hope you keep learning and keep growing and keep being kind to each other, and you know, keep making this world a little better place. So blessed be, and good night.